Yes. Good, how you doing? Yeah. Okay, so he canceled before, is that why you guys called me? I cannot understand what you're saying. So you want me to pick this person up? Okay, I'm parked. I see vehicle issues, not safe to pick up.
Can you see where it says more issues at the bottom, sir?
More issues, yeah.
You're gonna click where it says more issues, and then you're gonna see where it says none of these. You see where it says none of these?
Yeah.
Yes, you're gonna click on where it says none of these, and then you're gonna see cancel trip. And then you're gonna go ahead and click on it, and the following letter should be out of your screen.
Since the operation couldn't be completed.
Okay, good question. Do you have internet access while you're on the phone?
No.
What kind of phone company do you have?
Sprint.
That seems to be the reason why. So we're going to have a disconnection. We're going to click on none of these and change the trick. But we're going to give you a call back in 1 moment, okay?
Okay.
You can stay pulled over and go offline after that, okay?
Okay.
As you guys can tell, this was shot a little while ago. I was doing Uber driving and a random phone called me. I didn't know what it was, but I thought it was maybe Uber because it told me that they were Uber, and so I followed through the instruction they gave me in the beginning, and I got to a point where I was kind of like, even if it was Uber, it's like you're wasting my time. I just need to get back to work. I canceled a person's call that wanted the Uber pickup because they had told me on the phone to do so. So I was ready to get back to work, and they called again.
Okay, I canceled it, yeah. Yeah, I am. Oh, thank you. What is the reward, he said? Oh, appreciate it. Appreciate it, man. Gotcha, thank you, man.
Yes, sir, do you see where it says setup instant pay?
Yeah, it says instant pay, yeah.
All right, sir, and do you see the last four ending in your card, sir? Do you see the last four numbers ending in your card, sir?
Yes, I see it.
All right, sir, so what you're going to go ahead and do, sir, you're going to go ahead and click on that.
Okay.
The moment I suspected that it was not from Uber, I turned the camera around to make sure that I was recording for my security purposes. I feel like this has been done to a lot of people because later on I had to call Uber and check this kind of scam been going on, and they had even more scam than this, and this is just one of them. Before I even went in the depth of the call, I kind of had some unction in my spirit, which is the Holy Spirit, like telling me like, there's something off about it, about this whole situation. Some people may call it instinct, but to me, I know who it is. And so I relied on it, and that's when I started recording, and the moment started going down on the road of messing with my Insta payment, that's when I kind of knew this is off.
Yes, you're gonna click on the three dots and you're gonna see where it says edit, okay?
Okay.
Alright, and then it should show your first name, your last name, and your card number, correct?
I think it's offline, so it doesn't let me access that.
Yes, sir. So we're gonna go ahead and do so. We're activating your following promotion with the $50 in it, including the reimbursement for month. Yes, once again, sir, what we're doing is activating your promotion card. So what you're gonna go ahead and do, sir, did you click the last four ending in debit card, sir?
I did, but it's like, I think it's offline, that's why it's not letting me edit it. Yeah, it's not letting me pop up. It doesn't pop up basically my name. Nothing like that you're saying is popping up. I think it's because I'm offline.
All right, so you have to stay offline. So we're going to have a quick disconnection, and you're going to click on edit, and it should show your first name, last name, and card number, okay?
Right.
In the beginning, I had assumed that Uber do not just call somebody just to reimburse them about particular cancellation never done before. And then later on they had asked me for how much I made, and so I was like, if you're Uber, you should know how much I made. But I still told them how much I made just to test the waters. One thing that I was certain of was I knew that they can't just hack my account because it's like protected by Uber. Second, as long as I don't give out information, I knew that they couldn't scam or take my debit card number or anything. The other thing that I want to test out was this method that they used, which I do not know anything about. Kind of smart, but not too smart. You know what I'm saying? If you know anything about credit cards and how they work, I don't know who you scamming. Maybe people that don't know nothing about those things. That would make sense. This happened after that.
So they telling me to click on edit now. And I know it's a scam. I know it's a scam, but I'm gonna go through it so that people see that there is a scam out there. So they're telling me to edit this card, which is my instant payment. And so they're gonna give me like a number basically. And so I can fill out that number, the expiration date. And then basically what they're gonna have me do is they're gonna go back to instant pay, payout. And then they're gonna tell me to pay off basically my, so they call it, this is the number right here. And it's a scam, because you know it inside whenever it's something like this. But let me answer it. Hello, boss.
Once again, did you go ahead and click on enter?
Oh, yeah, of everything you said popped up.
All right, so now you're going to enter your following promotional card that you're going to enter manually to receive the earning, okay?
Okay.
So you're going to click on where it says card number. Do you see that?
Yeah.
Yeah, so you're going to enter 4232.
Hold on, give me a second. 4332. You said 4332?
No, 4232.
Oh, 4332.
For each you're going to enter 11/2023. So now you're going to click on where it says submit to. Note you see on your screen.
It doesn't let me go to the next screen.
All right, so we're going to have a quick disconnection. You're going to go ahead and do that once again. All right, so we're going to give you a call right back.
Why does it do that on just Sprint? Why can't my phone work while I'm on the Uber app?
Yes, sir. That is the following Sprint network, and that's how they work. So we're going to just have a disconnection and give you a call back once you go ahead and submit, okay?
You want me to just go get Wi-Fi? Because this is taking forever, and I need to be on the road. And $50 is like, I could have made that $50 by now.
Okay, so can you go get Wi-Fi?
Yeah, but like I said, it's going to take me time and disconnecting and reconnecting again. Right. It's taking forever.
Yes, sir. So I'm going to go ahead and get the Wi-Fi. We're just trying to use as fast as we can for you to get back on the road.
I know, but it's taking forever. I'd rather work right now and then deal with this later on when I get off.
Yes, sir. What we're going to go ahead and do, you're just going to hit submit, and we're going to hurry up and wrap it up. And just go ahead and hit submit. We're going to give you a last call back, okay?
I've been waiting for 20. I can't do it for $50 reward. $50 reward is not going to do me nothing.
Look, so this is not the $50 reward. You're also being reimbursed for the value of Mark and the time we were taking out of you on being on the phone.
So how much would my money be then?
All right, the total will be $75.28.
$75?
$75.
I thought Mark's right. It was longer than that.
Yes, sir. So what we're going to go is make sure you receive that. So you're just going to hurry up and finish the procedures to reach back on the road receive all following cash, okay?
May I speak to your manager? Because I need more reimbursement for this type of stuff. I mean, if I'm doing all this, taking my time, I need at least like 150.
Okay, so we also see here that you have another following promotion. I can go ahead and put that on like that.
Yeah, how much would it be though?
That one, I see it for $82.33.
Okay, how much would that be totally?
That would be in total $148.46.
Yeah, is there any way I can get 150 flat?
Yes, I can try to do that once you go ahead and finish this procedure.
$150?
That is correct.
Okay.
Okay, we're gonna have a disconnection. You're just gonna go ahead and hit submit. Yeah. We're gonna give you a call right back, okay?
Okay, thank you, bro. I appreciate it, man. You're helping me out. I have to go. I was gonna tell them I have to go to Africa or something like that. I need this money. Like, how do you not feel bad about people that you do that to? Like, I need to be working right now, and I need to be basically making my money too. And it's just like, now you're stealing and robbing from me $600 and whatever dollar that I made today, or this past few days. You're gonna take that money, and then like, what are you gonna do with it? Like, do you not feel bad that I had to work for my money, that you take it from me? It's like, you're doing this to people that are, you call them back, but you're doing this to people that are like foreigners and stuff like that, and this is not cool, man. Uber, you guys gotta get on this.
Hello?
Yeah, I kept on hitting submit, but a lost connection, I think, and it's asking me to re-enter the number again.
You're saying it's telling you to re-enter it again?
Yeah.
All right, so are you ready to re-enter it, or you can't hit submit again?
Yeah, should I write it down like on a paper or something?
Two three zero one.
For the name. He disconnected. No. First of all, I want to thank God because he revealed it to me before I even did anything. Like, I knew it. Like, you know it. Like, I don't know. First thing first, I want to glorify God for revealing and giving the eyesight. I know many people probably got schemed. If not, they will. So this is a warning to you guys, and that people are out there to destroy your life, basically. They don't care about you. They don't care about your family. They don't care that you got to make money. I will report this to YouTube. Not YouTube, but to Uber. And show that. And I have the recording. It's crazy thing is I left my camera on, so it was on sideways since the time he called me and to the time right now. And so if he calls back, basically I'm gonna preach the gospel to him. So what transpired is, first thing first, he asked me for, I was supposed to pick up this guy named Mark. This guy named Mark ended up, this guy, Mark ended up texting me on the Uber app, telling me basically, I forgot what he told me, but he said, Uber support, this is a test. Do not pick up this person. He's not allowed to get picked up. And so basically he gave it to me as like a promotion, like something I want because I'm cooperating with the people. But whenever Uber usually calls, it's from a specific number from a specific state. And I'm not going to say it because people are going to use it to scam. He used it from New York and was like, how are you gonna call me from New York? First of all, you calling me from New York, you a hustler. Second is you're trying to, well, he said, what did he say? Then he said, yeah, pull over so that you could be safe and stuff like that. So he made sure my safety. Once I was safe, he came back at me with, thank you for collaborating. Thank you for canceling the ride. We're gonna reimburse you for this ride share, and also we're gonna give you a $50 reward that you have won for today. And I was like, $50? What do I do? Uber don't just give out money. I was like, what do I do? But Uber, I actually like Uber because they are very, they take care of their customers on a base to base, and also they respond base to base right away. I don't know about Lyft or anything like that. They helped me out in the past when people like did the damage in my car. They was able to reimburse me. And so what I had problem was, like, Uber doesn't just call you and say, let me give you $50 because you have won a $50. For what reason? Because I heard what you said. He's calling me again now, actually, and how much. Preach the gospel to him and then call it a day. You know what I'm saying? Keep writing. Hello? It says it does not approve because of the name. What's the first name and the last name you want me to put?
No, so you're putting your first name and last.
Oh, mine. Okay.
Yes, that should be there. So you didn't do that?
No, I was waiting for your name because you hanged up on me. I didn't know how to call you back.
No, so we apologize. It was our disconnection. So what you're going to go ahead and do, sir, you're going to enter your full name and enter that number with the prompt expiration. So what do you see in your screen as of now, sir?
Right now, I see basically the card information and then my name I'm putting in right now as you tell me.
Okay, sir. So you're going to go ahead and enter your name, last name, and do that and give us a call right back, okay?
So you want me to give you a call? What's the number to call back?
This following number.
Okay, I'm ready. Go. So yeah, he called me from a phone number. So yeah, I'm gonna call him back and just tell him that, brother, that the things that you're doing, man, you're not helping nobody out. Okay, how am I word it? I'm gonna word it, brother. You ever heard of the gospel before? I'm gonna say thank you, man, for this opportunity. Can I tell you about Jesus? I'm gonna say that. Yep.
Please leave your message for 64. Please leave your message for 6.
I'm gonna just keep driving. I was gonna tell him the gospel, but I'm gonna just report this to Uber. Calls back, I'll record. Yeah, I tried calling you, it didn't go in.
Yes, that's a look. So did you go ahead and hit submit?
Yes. Thank you for this opportunity, by the way. I really appreciate it because now I'm able to provide, you know. Let me tell you this. You ever heard of Jesus before?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, Jesus loves everybody. And one of the things that he came to do is to help those people that are poor, to help those people that are sick, to help those people that are shortage of love. And if you ever in your life ever feel like you don't have a fulfillment of life, or you need to basically seek for something higher than you that loves you, just like how some at times people compare it to a mother's love, which I think is beyond that, like unconditional love, it would be Jesus. And it's like to have opportunity where people just randomly, you know, call you and ask you for your information or ask you for the information, brother, this is going to end up taking you in a wrong path that you don't want to in your life. And your life means a lot to God. And Jesus actually came to die for everybody. And it's including you.
Yes, sir. Once again, you are on the recorded line, sir. We're just trying to help. But did you go ahead and complete the procedure?
Huh? I'm telling you, Jesus loves you, brother. This is the love of God. I love you even though, you know, you're trying to make money off of me. That's fine, you know, people sometimes choose that way. But I'm gonna tell you this, brother, Jesus loves you. And you don't have to do this. He will provide a way for you. You need to attend the church. And you need to find brothers and sisters in Christ that will love you the same way. It's like, you don't have to do this. You don't have to choose this lifestyle. I know you grew up hustling. I know you grew up doing stuff like this. But this is not the way to life, brother. This is not the way to do it. You have other options. There's a lot of way to make money nowadays. You hear me? What's your name? I'm gonna call him back again. I'm going to just leave him a voicemail.
Please leave your message for 64.
Brother, it's me again. I wanted to say that Jesus loves you, man. And I'm going to keep telling you that because one day you're going to realize this is not the way. One day you're going to realize I hurt those people. It's like, you don't know who you're calling. The next person might have a kid that is sick or some family that they support. And this is their way of supporting it. And if you're not doing the right thing, man, and you're hurting people, the Bible says whatever you sow, that's what's gonna, that and only that you shall reap. And it's, if you choose to do this lifestyle where you scheme people or whatever you may call it, guess what's gonna come to you? This life is so short for you to be doing stuff like this. You should be finding ways to help people. You should be finding ways to, you know, uplift people. It's just like, the money will always come different ways. And if this is the only thing you was taught how to do, learn other things, learn other crafts, use your gifts. I know you have gifts because you have salesman, a voice, man. It's like, you could have convinced me if I, you know what I'm saying? If I wasn't saved, I'd be like, yeah, I'm trying to make $150. You know what I'm saying? Like, yeah, I'm trying to make another $50, but it didn't even seem right. It didn't seem right in my spirit at all. And so, man, I'm telling you, man, this is not the lifestyle to go. Go look up the Bible, get you the New Testament, start reading it from there. Jesus loves you the same way Jesus loves me. Jesus loves the same. The Father loves everybody the same way he loved his Son. And that's why he sent his Son. And so I'm telling you, you don't have no hope. You have hope. Don't listen to your homies. Don't surround yourself with people that do the same thing. Because guess what? Don't keep falling in the same issues, in the same situation. So turn your life around. Turn your life to Christ. Turn your life to God. And forget those. If those people that need to hear that, let them listen to it so they can come with. If not, you have the opportunity. It's no coincidence he called me, man. It's no coincidence he called somebody that is possessed by God. I can tell when somebody's trying to lie, when somebody's trying to steal from me or something like that, because I have the Holy Spirit that tells me and guides me. I'm glad that I stayed tuned to it, because I would have been, you know, robbed, whatever it seemed like. But anything that is touched up for me, the Bible says 7 times to come back to me. So I'm telling you today, for God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, whomsoever believeth shall not perish but have everlasting life. If you believe, you will have everlasting life with Christ. That's what matters. At the end of the day, everybody gonna get old, and this old way gonna go up. They gonna catch up to you, whatever you're doing, if you keep doing it. And this is a chance.
Your recording has reached the maximum length. To replay your message, press 1.
I don't need to
delete and re-record your message, press 3. For delivery options, press 4. To send us to mark urgent, press 1. To mark confidential, press 2. To mark urgent and confidential, press 3. Mark message mark urgent and confidential. To replay your message, press 1.
I pray that ministers to him. Well, I'm gonna go to my next ride.
A few things I wanted to clarify in this video. Thank you guys for staying tuned the whole entire video and watching it and getting to this part of the video. Appreciate it. Hit the like, share, comment, whatever you want to do. I really don't care at this point. I'm here to help somebody, not to gain anything from this. One thing that I want to mention is the Sprint phone had issues with, I think they fixed it now, but they had issues with you being able to receive a call and use the internet at the same time. That's why I had to get off the phone, get back on the phone, and he knew that already too, so he worked around that system. Second thing I want to show you guys is a screen recording of it. As you, if I expose too much of this scam, I think somebody else will learn of it and do something to others. But just watch out if you drive for Uber. It's just warning. Just watch out for those people that scam. I'm not going to show you screen recording. I actually thought about it for a little while, but it's no point. The reason that time I spent with this guy is I noticed that a scam and I wanted to expose it, and I was recording the entire time and I wanted to make this video. So I stayed throughout the whole thing to make sure that I got every part of it, so you guys can get educated about it. And I hope that was educational as much as inspirational to not do things to other people, because they have family, they have people they support, they have themselves that they support. You take another person's money without you having to work for it doesn't help you in the future. It helps you just temporary. Everything that you sow, you will reap the consequence. At the end of this video, what I wanted to say is that please stop with the scam. Come on, man. Thank you guys for enjoying this video. I have other Uber rides that I've had, like funny rides and stuff like that. You guys can check those out. I know it's a long video, but I thank you guys for staying tuned.